described and captioned media program. In the classroom and online, dcmp.org.
Aquarius Healthcare Videos presents What's Respect? We're all different.
How do you show that you respect differences in others? That's the question that Charlotte faced at her birthday party.
Charlotte passes cake to friends.
Here you go, Dave.
No, thanks.
Don't you like cake?
I'm fine.
Well, I have some fruit salad in the kitchen. Would you like some?
Sure.
Why aren't you having cake?
Because I can't have food with glutens in it.
What does that mean?
It means I'm allergic to things like bread, pasta, cereal, and cake.
Oh. I never heard of that before.
It's called celiac disease.
You have a disease? Get away!
You, get away from me! Don't touch me!
Hey, stop it!
Dave's disease!
Hey, cut it out! You're being stupid.
Hey, what's going on?
Dave has a disease.
What?
I just can't have food with glutens in it.
Dave's disease, no cake, please.
Hey, Mike, knock it off. No one makes fun of you because you have warts on your hand.
Yeah, so?
Well, warts come from a virus. What if he made fun of you? You wouldn't like it. Dave, I'm sorry. Mike's sorry too, right, Mike?
Yeah, I was just having fun.
Well, it's not fun for Dave.
It's okay.
When Mike began to tease Dave because he had celiac disease, Charlotte didn't ignore the teasing. She stood up for Dave. Her point was that we're all different and nobody's perfect. It's important to make sure you respect and accept the things that make people different. Whether you're allergic to cake or peanuts, or you have warts or whatever. When you accept people's differences, you're respecting people's differences.
Words appear.
If someone teased a friend because of their differences, would you ignore it or try to stop it? What would you say? What would you do? What's one thing that makes you different than anyone else? Think about it. Talk about it.
A title, Lesson Booster, a super way to learn. Cartoon of a boy dressed as a super aviator with a red mask and blue cape. Next, a title, What's Respect? Respecting everyone's ideas. Now, a teenage girl with long brown hair.
Respect is something everybody wants, right? What do you do if someone isn't respectful to you? That was a question a group of kids faced when they worked on a social studies project together. Here's what happened. Chelsea, Derek, Robbie, and Kelly were given a group assignment about the Great Pyramids in ancient Egypt. They began by sharing everyone's ideas. It was a good place to start.
The group sits at facing desks.
Okay, so does anyone have any ideas?
What if we built three dioramas that showed the pyramids in different stages of construction?
Ew, dioramas are so second grade. That's a dumb idea. Kelly! What?
Well, maybe we could have a web page. It could have a slideshow of pictures.
Derek, no one wants to look at a stupid web page. That's so lame.
No, it's not.
The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deaf-blind. These services include a library of free-loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approved lists of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.